So if you're Tampa, what happens now? Because they're probably as stunned as we are and everybody else who filled out a bracket. What happens? Where do they go from here? Because you have one of the best regular seasons in NHL history, and you get swept in round number one. What next?
Glinner, who's our producer. Glinner, we need a little time for this one.
Oh boy.
We can't rush through this right now, okay? We got time here. Don't mess around. I think if you're Tampa right now, you know that you have an elite team. You know that you have guys with character. You know you've got a great scouting staff, both amateur and pro level. You know that you're well managed, you have an outstanding owner, you got a great coaching staff. I think the first thing they have to do is exhale. They really do. They have to exhale. They've got to lick their wounds, because let's not sugarcoat it. This is a major disappointment for their franchise. There's no question about it. And bookending that with what was a historic season. So, Casey, I think right now they're going to have to lick their wounds. They're going to have to exhale. After that, with a clear head, then they can go forward and evaluate everything. But it's easy when things like this happen to, okay, we got to tear this apart. We got to rip this, change that, move this, move that. I don't think that needs to be the case. I just think that they need to be objective as they go forward and evaluate what they could potentially add into their group, maybe a little bit more jam, as we were talking about. Mm-hmm. But aside from that, I still think this team has a lot of the key pieces to be a Stanley Cup champ.
I think a little bit more jam, and you know, some of their key players are out with injuries, and getting the, you know, Hedman back in the lineup and Strawman back in the lineup would help in this situation. But I think, too, they had such a great season. You can't just take the negative. This is going to hurt for a while. It's going to sting. They're all elite athletes. But at the end of the day, it's taking away the positives. And like you said, what's that little change that will take us to the next step, because they haven't gotten that cup yet.
And I think that's one thing on that, just to double down since we have some time on it, is this is kind of the thing about Stanley Cup playoffs. And you look at the matchups. So when you're playing the same team night after night, it's the matchups. It's a matchup game. So very dissimilar to regular season where you're just in and out. You play that team. Maybe you got a back-to-back, home and home. But otherwise, you're playing the same team. And the matchup here for me was the power and the jam of Columbus versus the speed and the skill of Tampa. And the power and the jam won out. But so I think if you're Tampa on a go-forward basis, you want to add some jam.
It was incredible. Earlier today, Columbus put out a tweet saying, no brooms allowed inside Nationwide Arena. Mm-hmm. Nobody brought brooms in, but guess what? There's going to be plenty of brooms outside as they sweep round one and are moving on to round two of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Meanwhile, speaking of tweets, this one coming out from the Lightning. We don't have any words, and we know you don't want to hear them. We understand your anger, your frustration, your sadness, everything you're feeling. We get it. This isn't the ending we imagined and certainly not the one we wanted. Thank you for being there the entire way.